So in this video, I want to show you how I use the TradingView stock screener to find the best stocks to trade. TradingView is a software that is available for free. They also have a low-cost version. I believe it's only $14.95, and there's a lot of things that you can do with TradingView. Today, we're going to focus on the stock screener. So let's jump onto the computer right now, and let me show you how I personally use the stock screener to find the best stocks to trade. So let's actually go back here for a moment to just tradingview.com, because when you go to their website, this is what it looks like. And as you can see, there's no chart. There's some news here, I believe, and some basic charts. So in order to get to the stock screener, you can do it right from here. I recommend that you bring up any stock. It doesn't really matter. So here for this example, I'm just bringing up Apple. And as soon as you click on Apple, you want to click here on full featured chart as it comes up. So it's loading here for a moment. We will see right here, full featured chart. So you want to click on this. So once you do, you will now see a full featured chart that looks kind of like this. And you will see you have a chart here. Then at the bottom, you see that there's a stock screener, text notes, and on the right-hand side, you also have quite a few symbols. Now, let's talk about the first one here on the upper right. This is where you can have your watch list of the stocks that you're watching. Now, I like to look at the indices here. I like to look at Bitcoin, crude oil, and gold. These are the symbols that I'm watching. Now, here is where the stock screener comes in. The third or fourth button down here on the right-hand side is showing the so-called hot list. So there are three predefined hot lists that come up when you click on this. This is for the US exchanges, the volume gainers. This is where you see the stocks that really have had a lot of volume today. So for example, GE up 5.6%, Apple up 11%, Ford up 4.4%. You also see the percentage gainers. And this is where you see some weird stocks like Crex, no idea what they are doing. Well, as you can see, it was a penny stock trading at 80 cents, now trading at $3.80. So I didn't find this particularly useful. Same here for the percentage losers. For example, you have here Drio, Dario Health. Didn't find this particularly useful. However, this is where you can define your own scanner, and I want to show you how to do that and also the scanner that I personally like to use the best. So when you click on the lower left on the stock screener, it brings up the stock screener and you have predefined screeners in there. And look at this, all that we talked about right now, the volume leaders that we had on the right hand side, as well as the top gainers and the top losers, we have them right here. You see, it doesn't really matter which one you pick. Just pick any for now, because I want to show you, we pick the top losers, how I configure this list. As you know, right now, I am using this scanner to find stocks where I can sell put options. As the markets are crazy right now, I mean, today is April 28th. We are in day 46 of these crazy markets. And while the markets have been crashing and now are slowly coming up, selling puts has been really, really great. So the stock screener that I'm about to set up right now is for exactly that purpose. But as you follow along, you'll see that you can use this screener in many, many ways. And let me show you exactly how to set it up. So again, it doesn't matter. You just pick any of the predefined lists. I'm picking the top losers list. Now, this is where I like to go to filters, and I like to adjust the filters to meet my criteria. Let me show you one more time how to get there. You see this big blue button on the upper right here of this list. So when you click on filters, that's where you can adjust it. Here is how I like to adjust it. I want to see a percent change where the stock today is losing more than 2%. So I'm entering a minus 2 here. The last price, I like to take a look at stocks that are trading between $5 and $150. So this is just me. Yours might be different. I'm just showing you how to use this scanner. Now, in terms of symbol type, this is the third thing out of four that I'm going to change. Here, I'm only looking at common stock. So I'm unselecting depository receipt and ETFs. So again, Super easy. All I need to do is that I adjust four different settings. I'll leave the exchange as is, but the one thing that I'm looking for here right now is the volume filter. So again, just to briefly recap, I am changing the change percent to a negative 2. I'm changing the last to between 5 and 150, the symbol stock to common stock, and the fourth thing that I'm changing is the volume. I would like to see stocks that are trading at least 1 million shares per day up to whatever, more than 50 million. So these are the only four things that I'm changing. And by doing this, you see that right now I have 125 matches. Now, this is where right now, you see, top losers has a little asterisk there. So I have changed it. You can now save this screen as whatever you want. So you can use your own name. You see, I use the name where I said most volatile Markus. So this is where you could just say, okay, just a test to show how it works. So you can save these settings that you just did. And you see, then whatever you're picking, you can go back to just the test to show how it works. And you have again your 129 matches back. Now I want to show you how to adjust the columns here. This is the second thing that I do. But let me ask you, thus far, is this making sense? Is this helpful before we continue? Because if it is, do me a favor and click on like really quick so that I know that we are going at the right pace, that we are not going too fast, and that we are not going too slow. So if you could do me a quick favor, hit like, I would really appreciate it. And then I'd show you how to customize the comments. Thank you. Okay, let's go back to the screen here. And you see that now we have a lot of columns here. We have the ticker, we have the last price that is traded it, the change, we have the change in dollars. So that's the change in percent, that's the change in dollar, a rating, the volume, the market cap. And there are a lot of columns that I personally do not use. So here's the really, really cool thing. All you need to do to get rid of a column is right mouse click on it and remove the column. So I like to keep the ticker. I like to keep the last price. I would like to know this. And I like the percent change. I don't need the change in dollars. But again, for you, it might be different. This is why I want to show you how to do this in general. But I'm removing this column here. I also personally don't care about the rating. I do my own rating. So I'm removing this. And you're doing it by right mouse clicking on the column and remove it right here. I don't need the volume information because I already know that all of these stocks are trading between 1 million and above. So I can remove this. I also don't care about the market cap. Right mouse click and here we go. The PE ratio, not important to me. I'm removing this column. The EPS, I don't care about it. Again, you, it can be different for you. So you might care about it or not. Employees, don't care about this. And the sector is the last column and I leave this one in. Now, if you want, you can click on these three dots on the right hand side and you can add a bunch of columns. As you can see, there is a lot of information available. So you can add as many columns as you want. So the only columns that I like to see is the ticker symbol, the last price, the change in percent, and the sector. Now, also, in the same way as we have saved the filter, we can save the column layout. And the difference is that this is here on the left-hand side. So you see on the left-hand side, you have the column sets. Here, this is where we selected the filter. So we can go for volume gainers and it is still using the columns that we just defined. Or we can go for the top losers or what we have just saved. Just a test to show how it works. So we can now save our own columns here and we can save this in the same way that we say, okay, this is the best layout for columns. Just kidding. You get the idea, right? So you have two things that you can save. You can save your filter and you can save your column layout. So going back to the filters, you see the ones that we changed is that, we went to the change percent below minus 2%, last between $5 and $150. For the symbol type, only the common stock and the volume we changed from 1 million and above. For the column layout, this is where I choose the ticker, the last price, the change in percent, and the sector. So you can close the screener by clicking on hide here, and you can bring it back up by clicking on stock screener. And then you can quickly go through this and look at the stocks and see which ones of these you like. This was just a very brief intro on how I use TradingView, the stock screener, to find the best stocks to trade. Hope that you find it helpful. If you did, click on like and consider subscribing to the channel. This way you get more videos like this. Hey, talking about more videos, there's probably more videos popping up on the screen right now. If you enjoyed this video, just click any of these videos that interest you, and I'll see you in the next video.